once again,
try a half what I do with my own watermelon. Is that when I get the whole watermelon, I always find out that they are just, for me alone, I can't finish it within a week. As a result, that by the time I finish just half of it, the remaining just turn to water and I just trash it. So I said, okay, the best thing I could do, instead of cutting them into pieces and storing them in the fridge, I might as well just turn them into liquid. Just like orange juice, like apple juice. So what I do, I cut my watermelon into pieces, and then when I've cut them into pieces, I have so many pieces like that, which later on I'm going to put in the blending machine, and I will blend them and I will store them like this into some bottles like that. So which means that they will stay very well in the fridge, and I can easily come back anytime I need them. I can turn them into juice and then drink it. So for me, it's better. For this watermelon, I'm lucky that the ones I bought hasn't got the seeds inside it. But if it has seed, it means I just have to take the pain to remove the seed before I grind it. Otherwise, I will also be grinding the seed, and the seed are also very useful. So what I do now, this grinding machine is very, very portable. Cost just about $9 from Walmart, and I just have to feed the watermelon or any juice like cucumber, carrots, anything I want to do. I put them inside it, and then it's just going to liquefy it for me, like you're going to see it now. I'm going to fill the inside with my watermelon, as you can see. Then I cover it. Put this one there. Okay. So we turn it into powder, into a liquid form now. And what do you have? Let us see what we have. We need to remove the blade. Have this. It's beautiful. I love it. And then I can put them inside the bottle. Cool, isn't it? So that's what I'll do. And it also saved me cost of the, it saved me the cost of by not wasting watermelon, and then that's the way I can preserve it also, because one thing is watermelon cannot keep, from what I find out, you cannot cut half of this one and wrap it up in plastic and leave it inside the fridge. When you cut it in plastic and leave it inside the fridge, by the time you come back, maybe after 3 days or 4 days, you find out that the watermelon has already turned to water. And you can't do the game for it. So the best thing for me now is just to turn into liquid. I just turn it into liquid. And then I cannot stop it away. So I have enough. So I have, that is my watermelon, and then that's another bottle which I'm going to use now. So you could see that it's very, very economical, and you don't have any problem at all. So all these seeds now, just throw them away because you don't eat the seeds. I mean, you don't eat the bags, so you just throw them away. But if you say you have some rabbits or anything, you can use them to feed them. See, so that's what I do. And I don't have anything to waste at all. Even sometimes too, when I get my tomatoes, especially when I get plenty of tomatoes, I just blend them and I put them in the plastic bowls. And they keep inside the freezer very, very well. I don't have any problem at all with pepper, with tomato, with anything except the onion. You can't do onion like that. So the onion, you just have to leave it, because it is said that onion absorb bacteria. So as a result, don't leave any unused onion. Once you have cut onion, make sure you finish using it. Otherwise, it will have accumulation of bacteria with you. So here we are. And I'm sure you've all enjoyed what we have seen this evening. But from now on, keeping watermelon, it should no longer be a nightmare to you. You don't have to waste money. You don't have to think about how to store it. Because one thing is, once you have already got it like this, all you have to do is just juice it. Just mix it. I love it.